All right. Hello, everybody. I think we got this together finally. I'd like to thank everybody for being here. We got a few surprises. We got a lot of great, great entertainment tonight. A lot of good friends. Hope everybody's eating, right? We got a table full of food out there. Thanks so much for being here. And with that, as Mr. Frazier is ready, we're going to start playing a little music. All right, go.
Yeah.
shot completely unrehearsed and unplanned. We're just kind of deciding what to do out here while we're doing it. But it's great to see so many people here honoring Richard. He's a great guy. He's a part of our club. Want you to know, Terry gave me this shirt. This is one of Richard's shirts hanging here in front of us today. So, Richard's usually up here singing, so there he is. The drums too loud out there? Hold on, I have to fix the drums.
It's always fun playing with brothers.
Yeah. Try it now, Tommy. Waiting for Cody.
I'm ready.
Cody Kessler, formerly of No Fixed Abode. So we found him.
I'm not afraid to die.
Senator gave us a list of some of Richard's favorite Beatles songs, so we're going to do some more of those. How many of you were at a Christmas party on Friday? Good, yeah, not quite half. So what we do is we do Christmas songs, but they sound like the Beatles. So we're going to try one of those now. And wait a minute, I need something for this though. Hang on. So every year at our Christmas party, Richard would come and sing, and he always wore this hat. So Terry gave me this hat, or loaned it to me. And, you know, it's great having part of Richard here, and he'd always, you know, I always thought it was so cool that this Jewish guy would come to our Christmas party and sing all these songs about Jesus Christ, you know? So I guess, since he could do that, I guess a Patriots fan up here could wear a Bills hat. So.
He's a real nowhere man, sitting in his nowhere land, making all his nowhere plans for nobody. Doesn't have a point of view, knows not where he's going to. Isn't he a bit like you and me? Nowhere man, please listen. You have no.
courtesy of all of Richard's favorite songs. And this next one's going to feature a great keyboard player, Karen Hurley, doing all kinds of sounds back there, horns and strings and pianos and everything. And that guy over there, good friend of mine, I've known him for so, what's his name again? Cody.
Buffalo Bill.
I got the list of all Richard's favorite songs down here on the floor. All over the place now.
Thank you.
And another member of the club passed away about a year and a half ago, I guess it was. And this was a song he always sang. And then Richard took over singing it, and now Cody's going to sing it. One of the great ones is from the movie Help and the album. Beatles song this is supposed to sound like.
Wait a minute.
No, he's not ready. Oh, I'm not either.
Yeah, hello. We got three different songs going here.
Hi, Marcy. How are you? This is Marcy, one of our favorite Beatlemaniacs.
Receive her King, let every
Jim Hausheiser over here. He's a lead guitar player. The Beatle Maniacs, he sings all the George Harrison stuff. So, don't bother me, okay?
Yeah, don't bother.
This is the... That's why I wanted to sing a George song. He said, don't bother me. You know. So, yeah, this is the first song that George Harrison actually ever wrote. And, John and Paul were writing songs like crazy, and George said, well, maybe I can write one. And we just did it as an exercise to see if he could write a song. Son of a gun, he did. What the hell is it?
Under D. Okay, so besides the Beatle Maniacs, we also do a British Invasion show. Same group of people, sometimes. Sometimes different people, depends on who's available. Jimmy's going to sing another one, how about that?
You came
All right, this one's really going to feature Karen and Cody. You may have heard this before.
Thank you.
not on the list Gary gave me, but Rich, I know Richard liked to sing this one. And I always hated it when he did because I like to sing it too. But, you know. I don't need to charge for this. But, you know. Oh, we need a cowbell. Nobody has a cowbell. Here's one of the most popular Beatles songs ever. It's okay with me?
Wait a minute.
Hold on, we're just getting the key down because we don't seem to know what the hell we're doing. So, anyway, lots of audience participation in the end here.
So we're gonna do it again.
We need you all to help us when we get to the end of this song. So to Cody Lesser of No Fixed Abode, Opportunity Knocks.
Hey.
right. Help them out, everybody.
So Gary had asked me a couple of weeks ago, I'd like you to play a few songs. I said, sure, Gary. So I'm going to play three numbers. I have some tracks. No Beatle music, but we don't have any time to rehearse, but some good American songbook stuff, and I'm going to play three numbers. Let me just get this thing up to speed so I can play these numbers, all right? Bear with me a few seconds. First number is going to be Satin Doll. I tried to get a sound check. I noticed a big hall. I got my Bose system is good. I think I can get out the most of the people. Hey, Val, how do I sound? You can hear me?
Yeah.
What do you think? Not bad, right? Okay, let's give it a hit. They don't change with me. Could be dangerous. All right. Great bass, great drums. Great piano, you're not going to find better. Okay. Hey, Val, when do I get back here? Help me get back. I'm scared. What am I going to do? Second number, I'm going to play a song that everybody knows, Over the Rainbow, and this is my rendition, and I hope you like it. I have more trouble operating this thing than playing.
Thank you.
Again, my last number is we're gonna swing with this. It's called Sea Jam Blues. It really moves. And then I'm off. And then we got some other guys playing. And this is a great affair. And like I said, Richie used to come to hear me play. He was always nice to my wife. And Richie was a great guy. We loved him. And anyway, he would come and see me play a lot of jobs I did. He's a class guy. And this last one, like I said, it's been a sort of moves and it's kind of peppy, so it's a happy gesture, you know. Here we go. Sea Jam Blues. Number 6, I think. Here we go. There we go, all right. I need a sound man. Okay. Now, there's actually a horn line here. I'm playing on top of this trumpet. There's a couple of bars. And I play it on top of the trumpet, and I make my harmonica sound just like his horn. He'll hear the part. The guys that are musicians will understand it, so it's kind of cool. It's if I don't blow it. All right, that's it.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Oh, I'm glad you liked it. All right. Thank you. All right.
Give it up for Phil, will you? Yo!
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 Thank you. Bro Hurd. Thank you. We had a lot of names for each other. But he'll come down here. Yeah, everybody knew him as Rich. Rick. Richie.
Richard.
Richard. Who's Richard? Yeah, Woody gave him the name Richie.
Richie.
But one name he did have that nobody knows about is when he was in broadcasting school. He called him Cooter. What the hell is Cooter? This is a celebration, and thank you for being here. You love the Beatlemaniac? Is a hell of a drummer. Hello, brother. We had a lot of fun playing together. Got to open a dream for some national acts back in Rochester. But when we came down here, Sandy and I, we tried to get him to come down here, and it took 2 years, but he finally got his ass down there. So they got a Beatlemaniacs club there. You're gonna love it. So he did, and after a couple of years of playing in different bands and stuff, and playing in different locations, and he met this wonderful lady. Music was a big part, and if it wasn't for the Beatlemaniacs, we never would have been able to play in the Cameron Club, which was the highlight of his life. So, please give him one more round, please. There's so many musicians out here. A lot of fans, and thank you so much. We loved all of you. You gonna talk? Okay, I'll let you talk. You're scary.
Somehow, my best friend, Renee, roped me into coming to a party at Richard and Gary's. Apparently, it was a big thing to come to a party at Senator's. There was music, apple wine, beer. high school. I ran into him one time a few years later at a store in Avon, New York. If anybody who knows, Diane knows, where my parents had relocated once my dad retired from the state police. Little did we know that we lived a mile from each other, but we never asked each other, what are you doing here? Or why are you here? We just kind of like, kind of thing, because we hadn't seen each other in a long time. He always said, I think maybe I was stoned or something. I don't know. I was surprised to see him. We never exchanged phone numbers or addresses. Fast forward to February of 2016. Once again, I got talked into attending a multi-year class reunion in Rochester, New York. And lo and behold, there was Richard surrounded by a bunch of old friends that I hadn't seen in probably 4 years. We ended up talking for a very long time, well after the rest of the crowd dispersed. He flew back to Florida, I went back to my home nearby, and we figured we'd see each other at another reunion. 2 days later, I get a phone call on Messenger, okay? For those of you who use Messenger, you can make phone calls on it. I didn't know this. I see this message coming in and a phone number from a Rochester number, and it said, Richard Senator, and I'm like, what? You know, so I pick up the phone and he goes, hi, it's Richard Senator. I said, yes, I know, I saw your name on here. And so this began our nightly ritual of talking on the phone for probably 2 to 3 hours every night. This went on for about 4 months, and then I was invited to come here for a weekend. I took the plunge, flew down from New York, and our long-distance romance blossomed in the best time of my life. After 18 months of back and forth, I finally made the decision to retire and come down here to be with him. We bought a house together, planned our lives together, all the while being very happy and in love. Every morning we started with a kiss, and I love you. And many times throughout the day, we said, I love you to one another. And every good night ended with a kiss and holding hands till we fell asleep. His health took a huge hit after the stroke in March of this year. Although he pushed through the difficulties like the strong guy that he was, he promised to take me on the Beatlemaniacs trip to England, and we went. He walked just about everywhere, and I was amazed that he pushed himself the way he did. Unfortunately, his health declined in September and his body could just not withstand any more hits. Taking care of him was my priority and my honor. Being a healthcare provider for 32 years, I was and have been upset that I could not do more for him. He was everything to me and I miss him fiercely, and I know he would be both honored and happy to know that he made such a difference in so many people's lives here in the Villages. The Beatlemaniacs Club was so important to him, and he loved playing and singing every Friday for the last 9 years. I know you all miss him already. No one can ever take his place. Just remember him for the wonderful, funny, and talented man that he was.
Mango tequila was one of my brother's favorite tequilas, and I hope you all will join me in a shot to Rick Senator, my brother, my bro.
Yo!
All right, we're going to continue with the festivities here. We got lots more music. We're going to bring... Where's Ira?
Ira.
Where's the rest of the Beatlemaniacs?
Right here.
Get your butts up here.
How about the new Kamehameha Club?
hope everybody's enjoying the pictures and stuff over here. There's a lot of great memories there. A lot of people can actually see Richard with hair. Everybody, about 8 years ago, there was a couple here, Bob and Wendy, and we became very good friends. And Wendy played bass and Bob played guitar. And Bob and I went to a few different groups together. And Bob looked at me one day and said, with his English accent, "Let's play in my house." So instead of going to the groups, we started there, and other friends came, and it started the back row band. Of course, most of the people would sit in the back row, and the Beatlemaniacs. And it was a great time, and Richie eventually became the drummer, and he taught us so much about singing, about rhythm, about friendship. He was always there coaching us, and we miss him. This is dedicated to him, my butcher. Love you, Richie. Look down and help us out. Make sure you keep an eye on us. Thank you, Ira. It sounded just like you.
Gary Davis has something special. Gary doesn't sing very often, but told us he wants to sing, so we're going to stay the hell out of his way. I don't want to get hurt or anything.
We're bigger than you are.
So for those of you who don't know, Gary runs the Advanced Acoustic Guitar Club on Tuesday mornings at 9 o'clock at the Churchill Rec Center. Great guitar player. You'll learn a lot if you play guitar. And if you don't, you'll hear a lot of great music. Phil comes and plays. And so I go occasionally, and he's getting ready.
We're getting there.
This is something that we rarely hear.
Me too.
So I'm nervous. Look at him, he's shaking. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, Gary Davis.
You may regret this moment, I don't know. So I was talking to Gary, because I want to do something just a little different other than just more Beatles songs. So I said, does he enjoy Disney at all? No, he never went to Disney. He didn't bother with Disney. But he's always wanted to go to Australia. So I happen to have, from Advanced Acoustic Guitar, a song from Australia that we played maybe 2 years ago that I've never sung. So we're going to give it a shot. My Australian cap here. You might recognize the chorus. If you do, I hope you sing along because, once again, I'm not a lead singer. I'm just kind of a background kind of guy. So at any rate, a melody goes something like this. Explain them as I go through each verse because there's a lot of Australian slang that I've never heard before. And I guess this is actually a true story, and I know that for a fact because I found it on the internet. Okay, so once a jolly swag man came by a billabong, through the shade of a coolabah tree, and he sang and he watched as he waited till come a waltzing Matilda. Okay, so a jolly swagman. Well, swag is like a duffel bag you put in your bag. So here's a guy walking around with a duffel bag. He's basically a hobo, right? So this is what he is. A swagman is basically a hobo, and he can't buy a billabong. A billabong is a pond or a swamp, if you will. Basically, go there, get some water. Under the coolabah tree. Well, the coolabah tree is just a eucalyptus tree, but they kind of distorted the way the Aborigine actually pronounced it. So it's a eucalyptus tree. Saying as he watched, waited till his billy boiled. A billy is a tin cup they keep water in, and so he would make tea in his billy, so waiting for his billy to boil. And he'll come waltzing Matilda. And I always thought Matilda was a kangaroo. Kind of made sense, right? No, Matilda was the bag on his back, and he's walked around with his bag. They called it Waltzing Matilda. So here we go. We have a chorus, and I hope you'll sing along with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he was, and he waited while he was. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Jumped a swag man and grabbed him with me, and he sang as he stole away the tucker bag. Come a waltzing Matilda with me. Okay, so here we go again. A jumbuck. He gets a jumbuck. Jumbuck is a sheep. Sheep goes on the property. And of course, he'd grab whatever he could to eat. So at any rate, so that's a John Buck. Stowed him in his tucker bag. His tucker bag is just a knapsack he would keep with him to put food in. And a John Buck, of course. So back to
Waltzing Matilda, Waltzing Matilda. You come a waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he walked and waited till his curly boil. Come a waltzing Matilda with me. Up rode the squatter, mounted on his thoroughbred. Came the trooper, 1, 2, 3. Where's the jolly John Buck you got in your tucker bag? Come a waltzing Matilda with me.
Okay, so the squatter. The squatter is actually the landowner, but of course, squatting rights, whatever. And he had his herd of sheep and everything there. So all of a sudden he sees this guy apparently took one of the sheep. And down came the troopers. Well, we know what troopers are, right? So at any rate, they were going to arrest the poor guy. So at any rate, here we go.
Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he watched and waited till the curtain boiled. Come a waltzing Matilda with me.
And I like having to reinterpret these things because it gives me time to change the page. So anyway,
up jumped the swagman and sprang into the billabong. You'll never catch me alive, said he, and his ghost may be heard as you pass by the billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me.
So the poor guy did not want to get arrested. Last thing he wanted, so he jumps into the pond. I don't know about you, but I would never want to jump into a pond that has crocodiles and whatever else is in there. So at any rate, his ghost is there forever. And the final chorus, here we go.
Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Whose ghost may be heard through the past by the billabong.
Give it up for Mr. Gary Davis. Good job. Who knew? Who knew Gary Davis had that kind of talent? Singing and playing the guitar at the same time. Holy moly, I've never seen him do that before. I'm worried. Gonna be up here taking my place pretty soon. Here comes the lovely, adorable, and talented Mr. John Murphy. A lot of people, the people in the Beatlemaniacs know this, but a lot of you may not. John spent 38 years in prison. And he's
watching people just like him.
Yeah. he was the warden when I, no, I wasn't.
What are we doing, John?
This is a song about rain. This is a song that's got something to do with rain. I'm trying to explain it to Gary. The long and winding road. You mentioned rain or something. This is a Paul McCartney song, and I know that, as Gary said, Richie did love the Paul McCartney song. So, and Gary asked me why I do this, and I told him I would. My knees do not bend because you see they're messed up. And the iPad's down here. Okay, so this should be really kind of cool. I may not have the last verse of this in the song, but don't worry about it. The long and winding
Tell us what to do now.
Everybody's getting ready here. You heard Terry mention that we took a Beatle Maniacs pilgrimage tour this past July. And as Terry said, in March, Richard had a stroke and he was having some medical difficulties, but he was starting to rebound and he was still able to come to band practice. And he said, come hell or high water, there was nothing that was going to stop me from going on that trip. Damned if he didn't go. And he soldiered through everything that we did. He required our help from time to time, but he pushed his way through it. And the crowning achievement for all of us musicians, especially those of us who have been there for the first time, we got to play live on the stage at the Cavern Club, which I don't have to tell you guys that the Cavern Club was where it happened for the Beatles. That's where they really took off. Played there, 295 times?
292, I think.
292. 292.
You don't come to enough of our meetings.
It's just numbers, for Christ's sake.
Yeah, 292.
I get this every week. So anyway, and Richie actually came up and played, I think it was like six or seven songs on the drums, and he sang his signature song, No Darling. And,
Jimmy's not going to sing that.
No, but we have a surprise here, hopefully. And little did we know it at the time, that was the last time we would ever see or get to play with him on stage. And it breaks my heart. So, the two songs that Gary and I are going to do, if I can pull myself together here, are the ones we did on the Cavern stage, and these are for Richard. Gary and I go sing.
Yeah, go ahead. twice. Come on, baby, don't be overnight. Say travel on the one at the night.
Get up and dance if you want.
All right.
Everybody knows this song. So.
Okay.
Yep. One, two, three, four.
She was just 17. And you know what I mean. The way she looked was waiting me home.
Changing the drummers now, because I think it was Bob Turnbull played behind us for the first couple of songs, and I turned around, and the cavern stage is a little tiny stage, and there's this little opening and some stairs that you have to go up to get to it, and here comes Richard with his cane, you know, just kind of hobbling up there, and I'm just looking at this, I'm saying, this is the strongest, bravest man I've ever seen in my life to be able to get up there and climb in, and the drums are like pushed up against the back wall, so you got to kind of squeeze your way in, and I tell you, the guy just was amazing on that trip. And to get up on that stage and do what he did, and he played great, and he sang great, and he played, a lot of us sang and played, and he played for most of us. So, what are we doing?
We're going to
the key of F Marsh.
You got it.
So,
we're going to try this song. I'm going to try this song.
You know what? You know what, Gary? Well, I'll help you out if you need some help.
It's kind of a song that my brother's known for.
Yeah.
So, here goes, bro.
Let's go.
No.
Let's go.
Well, hey, darling, please believe me, I'll never do you no harm. Believe me when I tell you, I'll never do you no harm. Well, darling, Terry's Ukulele Club. Yes. Do some special songs for Richard.
Thank you. Gary.
Hey,
what? You might want to make an announcement. No, I don't know. What does it say?
I've just been handed this wonderful note here that so far the Buffalo Bills are crushing the Cowboys 31-3. Check. What are you not getting?
Sessions. Apparently, Paul had the melody in his head for quite some time, and he played acoustic guitar and sang the lead vocals and vocalized part of the bass instrumentation on this song. John and Ringo played percussion, and George apparently did not play on the song. The final take was take number 65, which was used on the album, and Richard always liked this melody called I Will.
One, two, three, Bruno, Salomon, love.
here's a little trivia about the next song, and I know how much Jim Frazier especially appreciates the trivia. The expression "between the devil and the deep blue sea" is actually an idiom that offers two equally awful choices. It's been around for at least 400 years, and it has to do with the seam, which was the devil, around a ship's hull near the water. If a sailor tried to caulk the seam in the heavy seas, he was in danger of falling overboard and drowning. But if the seam wasn't caulked, the ship could fill with water and sink. The song was published in 1931, music written by Harold Arlen and lyrics by Ted Kohler, and was first recorded that same year by Cab Calloway. George Harrison did his version at George Formby Convention in Blackpool, England, March the 3rd, 1991. It was filmed for a UK TV show, which was broadcast the following year. My cousin sent me the video version some years back, and I loved it, so I opted to learn it on ukulele. Richard would listen to me playing, and he would often say something like, "Sounds good, babe." So this is for Richard.
One, two, three.
Some great notable musicians on it. And being Jake aficionados, we listen to the album a lot, and for that reason, I wanted to play it today.
One, two, three, four.
Long, long, long.
1924 by Isham Jones and Gus Kahn. Later that year, it was recorded by Ray Miller's orchestra with Isham Jones conducting, and it was a number one hit for almost 2 months. George was a big fan of Joe Brown and loved his ukulele renditions of old songs. Joe did this song at the Concert for George in 2002, which was held a year after George passed. The song closed out that concert and all of Joe's concerts, and I feel it's befitting for our little group to play for Richard. It's called I'll See You in White Dreams.
you. That's the end of this call. How about the ukulele club, huh? Yeah. Okay, so.
Let's close this video.
You know, every meeting of the Beatlemaniacs will end with the same song. You might know what it is. But if you don't, you're going to find out. So what we'd like is everybody who played here, performed here tonight, to come up, sing along with us. And we'd like everybody out there who's sitting down to stand up and sing with us. We're going to sing this off for Richard. Just to end, what a great night. How about the great time Terry and Gary put on, huh? This is such a great tribute to Richard. And we're very thankful that we all had Richard in our lives. He made us all better people. And certainly, we're very thankful to Richard and Terry for putting this whole thing together and doing such a great job. And thanks to everybody who came. I'd like to thank both of you for staying. Safe.